A lot of you are at home, and then you don't have any bills, and then you don't have any worries, you don't have anything to wonder about. It's all there. Amen. And that's the same thing, same way we honestly should be as grown-ups. You know, the Lord's providing us with everything we need. Sometimes we get beside ourselves and feel like we got to take it all. Amen. But I want to give the young people a word today. Amen. We read on it on Tuesday night in 1 Peter 2 and 9. And I want y'all to know this. This is something important. It's imperative that you know this. Amen. I say this. You see, there are people in the world. They have self-esteem issues. They have all these different issues and worries and struggles and mental battles. And they don't have nowhere they can receive some help. But I want all the children of God to know this today. Amen. You are special. Amen. You don't need no boy to tell you that you look pretty. Are you beautiful? Amen. They should already know this. They should know that from their parents and from the ones around here. Amen. Young ladies, you are beautiful. Amen. You are wonderful. Young men, you're going to be strong in this thing. Amen. Strong in the brotherhood. Amen. We don't want anything else to take our young people away. Amen. I remember sitting on that row when Sister Gabby sitting there when Minister Mason would be up here. I remember preaching that message about not letting the world get our youth. Yeah. And I remember it wasn't too short after that. It seemed like we started losing our youth. Yeah. And then we started disappearing, going over into this, going over into that. And I remember it very, very vividly because at the time I just graduated. Amen. And I was working, trying to get myself established. But I found out how I started to draw further and further away from the Lord. Amen. Because I had goals I wanted to accomplish, but I was going about it the wrong way. Amen. So I want to tell our young people and our parents, we can work together. Yes. Amen. There don't have to be no more falling off. Amen. We should be bringing them on back in. Amen. Amen. There's a lot of young people that should be here today. Amen. But they're not here for whatever reason. But we can continue to encourage them. Amen. We're going to continue to tell them, come on. Amen. You can make it. Amen. It don't matter what you did. It don't matter that you don't come to church as often as you feel like you should. Just come on. Don't worry about nobody passing no judgment on them. Because last time I heard, we all are sinners. Amen. Every last one of us are sinners. Amen. We all have come short. I heard my cousin, Brother Brandon Williamson, last night. I don't think he don't know I heard. He's at work. And somebody had said something to him. And before you know, he said, we all have come short to the glory of God. Amen. And I don't know if he was just saying that to just get under their skin, but it caught my ear. I said, ooh. I said, he, you know. I said, if I could just get him on here, if I could just keep talking to him, eventually he'll start coming in the door. Yes. That's just the belief I have. Amen. Amen. I always grew up believing that all of us should be here. Yes. Amen. We're only as strong as our weakest link. Amen. And young people, this is what I want you to know today. This is in 1 Peter 2 and 9. But ye are a chosen generation, a royal priesthood, and holy nation, a peculiar people, that ye should show forth the praises of him who hath called you out of darkness into his marvelous light. Amen. Young people, did y'all hear that? Amen. Ye are a chosen generation. Amen. Amen. That instantly means that the Lord handpicked you out. He handpicked you out.
Amen.
He said, I got Sister Gabby. This is what I'm going to make for her. This is how I'm going to develop her. Amen. And then she may go through this at school and that at school, but I'm making her. Yeah. Amen. She's going to be someone very special. Yeah. Amen. She may be one of the greatest praying women this church has ever seen. Yeah. Amen. I'm going to create Brother Xavier Williams. Amen. I'm creating him in my image. Amen. And he be able to stand at school. Amen. Be able to have a stand wherever he may go. Amen. That the world don't change his beliefs.
Amen.
That it don't change him from going from this thing to the other.
Yes.
Amen. That he don't be a blender. Amen. How many of y'all don't want to be blenders today? We got enough blenders around here. Amen. Amen. If you ever notice the one that stand out, be the one that go through the most. But that's all right. Amen. Because you are of a chosen generation. Yes. A holy nation. Yeah, that song, that song, and that appreciation. We that holy nation. Yeah. Holy nation. Yeah. You got to believe that in your heart. Yes. Amen. Don't let nobody tell you no
But Jesus in me. Jesus in me. He's good. And he's good all the time. No matter what's going on. No matter what's going on in this world. I got somebody that I can depend on. I got somebody I can go into my secret closet. And I can say, Lord, help. It ain't about those multitudes of words. But Lord, help. I want you to know that you are a chosen generation. Think about that for a minute. Chosen. I think about the Jews often. I think about how they rejected Jesus and they gave us a chance. Amen. But he chose me. He chose me. My last name is Jesus. It ain't Davis. It ain't Williamson. It ain't Mason. But Jesus. How many of y'all know that today? That Jesus will be there for you through it all. All you got to do is just trust him. Yes, amen. I heard a sister say, we got so much power. Yes. So much power. Y'all believe I got power? Yes, sir. Y'all say, I got power.
I got power.
I got power.
I got power.
I got power in Jesus' name. Yes. Y'all got it. Yes. Y'all got it. Yes. Y'all can affect everybody. You ever notice when a young child or somebody come up and they start giving praises, the rest of us, we start getting excited, don't we? We say, oh, look at them, praising Jesus. We know it's from their heart. We know they're not putting on no show. We know it's sincere. And that touches the heart, don't it? What comes from the heart touches the heart. Amen. We're different. You have to accept that. You just have to accept that you're different. Amen. It's not a bad thing. It's not a bad thing at all. I thought about what Ella Lynch said the other Sunday, and I laughed because it seemed like every time you say something in the pulpit, something at work happened that, you know, parallels with that. My boss was actually saying, what church you go to? And I'm telling you, he asked me this at least once every 2-3 weeks. And I tell him, I said, Pentecost Church of God. He said, oh, you're Pentecostal. I said, yes, sir. He said, oh, so you guys speak in tongues, huh? And I thought about what Ella Lynch said, I said, yeah. And I was happy to say, yeah. He said, all right. And then we went on by that day. But it's okay to be proud of who you are. Yeah. Be proud of what you represent. Don't be ashamed of it. Don't be ashamed of it. Young people, don't be ashamed of it. Don't be ashamed of it. Because whatever that's against it, it won't be ashamed. It won't be ashamed. So why should you be ashamed? Amen. I just want you guys to know this. Everyone knows, a peculiar people, that you should show forth the praises of him who has called you out of darkness. Clap your hands. What it says? A peculiar people. And you should show forth the praises of him that has called you out of darkness into his marvelous light. Hasn't he called you into a marvelous light? Why don't you stand on your feet today? Hasn't he called you into a marvelous light? Don't you have a praise in your heart? Hasn't he done something for you? We ought to say glory.